everyone, and welcome to my channel, Delicious Kitchen, where I, Hiba, share delicious and easy recipes for everyone to make and share with their family and friends. Today we're going to make a no-sugar granola. It's very easy, very delicious, very crunchy, and quite healthy too. You can enjoy it for breakfast with fruit and yogurt, on its own as a snack, or even as a topping on your favorite ice cream. So, without further ado, let's get into this. For this recipe, you're going to need 4 cups of old-fashioned oats. Here I'm adding 1.5 cups of chopped almonds and hazelnuts, but feel free to add the nuts of your choice. Next, add in 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 cup of melted coconut oil. You could also use avocado oil if you'd like, and 3/4 cup of molasses or honey, or a mixture of both. You'll want to get in every last drop of that molasses or honey, so make sure you do that. Please do not skip the salt, it's very important, it's going to bring out the flavour in your dish. I'm adding 2 teaspoons of vanillin, but you could just use the regular vanilla extract here. Then you're going to mix. Make sure you mix really, really well until everything is very well combined and coated with the molasses and oil mixture. Keep mixing, mix until everything is very well coated with the oil, molasses, or honey mixture that you've got. You want everything to be very well combined. Then you're going to transfer your granola onto a baking sheet that's been lined with parchment paper. The thickness of your granola will depend on the size of your baking dish. I'm using a 23 by 15 inches, but if you want thicker granola, then use a smaller baking dish. Now you're going to bake your granola in your preheated oven at 170 degrees Celsius or 338 degrees Fahrenheit for 20 minutes. After 20 minutes of baking, take out your granola and add in your favorite dried fruits. I'm adding 1 cup of raisins, but feel free to adjust the amount of dried fruits you want in there and the type of dried fruits. You could also add in cranberries, dates, or whatever your heart desires. Make sure that you mix it all in very well. And then make sure that you also press down on the granola when you're spreading it so that it sticks together. This is going to give you the lovely chunks when the granola is ready. Then you want to put it back in the oven and bake again for another 15 to 20 minutes. Make sure you keep an eye on it so the fruit doesn't burn. While your granola is baking in the oven, go ahead and take out your favorite chocolate and cut that into chunks to add it to your granola. Of course, this step is optional, but I think that the chocolate adds in this amazing richness and sweetness, and it's just so decadent in there. So I wouldn't skip this step if I were you. I'm using a mixture of chocolate and hazelnuts, bitter chocolate and pistachios, and just plain old bitter chocolate, but feel free to use any chocolate that you enjoy eating on its own. Make sure your granola has cooled down completely before you add in your chocolate, otherwise your chocolate's just going to melt. After you add in your chocolate, break it into the size that you'd like. Make sure you keep in some chunks in there because it's really delicious with the chunks. And that's it, you're done. I've served mine on some yogurt with fruit, but you can serve it on ice cream, with fruit and yogurt, or even as it is, plain as it is. It's very delicious, it's very crunchy, it's sweet, but it doesn't have any sugar, so you don't have to feel guilty about eating this. It is amazing. If you like this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more delicious and easy recipes. Thank you very much for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.